in a couple of days off and you get to see so much. It's an extraordinary place. You've got a great place here. Dale Julie's glass place, which is fantastic. Wow. It's fantastic stuff. It's great. Wish we had longer here. What can I tell you as the world beckons? What happens on tour? Well, tonight we're doing stuff in three albums. The most famous of which is Selling England by the Dollar. I mean, also the 40th anniversary of Spectrum Mornings. You get to hear a bit of stuff from At the Edge of Light. So the next few things are from that as well. That's been so warmly received, and that's great. Next one is Under the Eye of the Sun.
Thank you. Of course.
We'd like to keep the museum doors open as well, of course. Your glorious exhibits. Thank you. Thanks so much.
No problem, of course.
Not only its anniversary, but, well, there's a couple of things. It was my favourite Genesis album. And at that time, John Lennon said he liked us, which was a big deal. The trouble was there was no social media, you couldn't tweet it, so... You know, how many years later, 45 years later, the world gets to, can't do the maths. Gets to hear that story. But it's nice, you know, that, because we'd spent a lot of time when we were kids listening to Beatle records, of course. So, hey, we're going to do another couple from the new album. This one, we kick off with Fallen Walls and Pedestals, and we go straight into Beasts in Our Time.
Thank you.
as I said, it was the birthday of, or the, well, 40 years old for Spectral Mornings. Doesn't seem that long when you look back. Goes very, very quickly. This one is called Virgin and the Gypsy.
Thank you.
some of the general ones. It's not all blessed up. It's mainly blessed up. But sometimes, it's, you know, we take it down a bit, which is kind of nice. Thank you. You like 12 strings? You know, back in the day, with Genesis, which I know you're interested in, we used to have these, before you had these sort of, you know, tuning devices where you could see it like that, you know, it's like, we used to have all these 12 strings, and sometimes it would take 2 hours before the show to tune them up. And then Mike Rutherford would say to me, I think I'm going to change the strings on this one. That's what happens when you use 12 strings. Let me, yeah, exactly. Let me discourage that in the young immediately. We're going to do another one from Spectral. We've got another one or two from that. This one is an instrumental version of something that was a vocal tune on the last, on Spectral itself. And this one's called Tiger Moth. Thank you. Thank you so much. What am I going to say to you right now? spectral was, you know, there was a kind of subtext. You know, if music, if there's a subtext, it's all about re-energizing and healing. Something goes with music, but there's also the film with spectral, the idea of maybe the possibility of survival, of, you know, making it beyond this plane. And so much of the album was about that. This next one was really kind of, almost a kind of successor to the guitar solo that was there on Firth of Fifth. A lot of people liked that, and so decided to do a whole. The whole thing was like that, you know, so people could fly with it. So this is the title track, this is Spectral Wonders.
Thank you.
That's Craig Blundell on the drums. We're going to take a 20-minute break now, and then we'll come back with the second half.
Thank you. Thank you. When it comes round to me, church and stand. My voice I've chosen, but the name has been led. Trouble was. home. She dabs her skin with pretty smells, concealing to me. I will make my bed, she said, but tell to go. Can she be delayed for her cinema show? Cinema show. Romeo locks his basement flat, the scurries up the stairs. Hell high and floral tie, the weekend millionaire. I will make my bed with her tonight, he cries. Can he fail? Oh,
Deja Vu, hope you like it.